It's not possible. You see, there is even a fundamental constitutional provision. It says every tribunal set up to adjudicate a case must be composed in a manner to guarantee its impartiality. So the CJ has loaded a group of people with his appointees, and you are now saying he should recuse himself. Everybody knows that the person who pays the piper dictates the tune.
But one other thing, if I can just add a perspective, one of the provisions of the tribunal is also that when a case is reported to the CCB, the CCB takes that case straight to CCT. And, you know, so I'm wondering how the NJC angle comes here. That's one. Secondly, the CCB is for public officers, which the CJN is. The NJC is for judicial officers. So how does the position or office of the CJN differ from judicial officer and public officer? No one has been able to persuade me on that.
Let me tell you, for the purpose of the CJN, because they've said it violated the provision of asset declaration,
which is a public
officer.
Okay.
So I believe sincerely that this matter should go to the CCT.
So why is all the legal apparatus, all the judicial apparatus pointing in the direction of the NJC?
Because once you say judges must first of all determine the culpability or otherwise of a judicial officer in a matter that is not related to the performance of his function, then you are more or less saying the medical association should first of all sit over a medical doctor's matter before he can be formally charged. Once the matter does not fall, I believe that if the CJN collected bribe in handling a case, that falls within his official capacity.
Yeah.
Then you can take that to the NJC. But anything that the CJ is said to have done that is not related to his function as the CJ of Nigeria will have to go as a public officer to the CCT.